let's start, ladies. So it's number one, it's trending. And as they said, love it or hate it, but you can't ignore it. So what has the reaction been? I mean, how has life been post the Fabulous Lives of Bollywood Wives?
It's been very overwhelming. It's been, I'm kind of on this cloud because I've never experienced something like this. And I think more than anything, you know, they say you feel gratitude and thanks. I understand the true meaning of it now because I'm feeling so grateful and I want to thank everyone out there because it's just amazing to see so many positive, loving people out there. It's just the love, I can actually feel it.
And you know, Maheep, what I was just reading, someone's written, my spirit animal is Maheep. Maheep, who's now become the queen of memes. So have you been seeing all that?
I am seeing it all and I'm loving them and I'm laughing. I love it. I mean, honestly, Shania was telling me that, Mom, listen, this is a good thing when they make memes on you. So I'm loving it. Honestly, just keep bringing it on because it's too much fun.
And for someone who in the show we see is so upset with criticism and trolls, rightly so, if anyone attacks your family, anybody would, you know, but you seem to be taking this pretty well, huh?
You know what? I used to get very, very upset with the trolls. I used to focus on that. This whole lockdown, I've just changed my whole perspective. Now I am, and especially after the show, even more so, because the love is just so overwhelming. The you know, the blessings that they're giving my children, and I'm just feeling the warmth so much. The trolls are just noise in the background, and they can keep on, go for it, whatever rocks your boat, I don't care. It doesn't concern me, and go for it. That's all I can say. I'm just not focusing on them, for sure.
And for Seema, as they said, you know, after the show, a lot of love was coming for, you know, Maheep and Seema. And somebody said, come on, put Seema in one separate show, just Seema. Seema, what do you have to say to that?
I want to say that without my wingman, I will not see the side of me. So the thing is, they bring out the best in me, which is why, you know, they've liked that side of me because that side of me comes out when I'm in my comfort safe zone. And this is my comfort, my safe zone.
So, but honestly, there have been reactions. A lot of people, as I said, you know, love it, hate it, you can't avoid it. Some people have gone, oh, it's a cringe binge. Some people have analyzed, why do we need to watch it? On the other hand, everybody saying, don't analyze it. Just watch it for the way it is. And this is what we need, the laughs. Because you had clearly said when we spoke first, yes, we want you to laugh at us and laugh with us. So what has been your reaction to that criticism that's been coming, you know? Like, do we really need to watch this? Why do we need to see their lives? The privileged lives of, you know, the lives of privileged people. What do you have to say to all that?
It's their prerogative. Watch it if you want to watch it. Don't, if you don't want to watch it. But you're not meant to analyze this show. You have to take it for what it is. If I think that whatever I'm absorbing from this whole thing, it's more positive than negative. I've actually not looked at the negative side because my mind, what you can't see, what you don't hear, cannot bother you. So I'm loving this little bubble again. And if I've made people laugh, and as a group, we've made people laugh at us or with us, job well done. Because I don't think there's anything in the world that feels better than laugh. And especially at the end of a year like 2020, you guys have, everybody has stress in life. And yes, that watching a show like this, if you can just laugh and forget your worries, I mean, what feels better? For me, that is like a high.
Mahi, what about you? What do you have to say? As I said, somebody called you their spirit animal. A lot of people was like, oh, why is she swearing? And of course, you've clarified that accent for someone who's grown abroad. And she rightly described her accent as a kitschy accent. So, I mean, what do you have to say?
I mean, I'm finding it really strange to tell you honestly that they are analyzing or giving a critical thing on this show like this. It is a reality show. And like Seema said, you know, laugh with us, laugh at us, just enjoy it. It's not Gone with the Wind. It is not Mughlaism. It is what it is now. What should I say? I really don't know what more to say to this because it was never, I don't think it was ever meant to be analyzed and, you know, spoken about so much. But I mean, so be it. They're talking about it. That's what's good.
Which is so, and also like you've grown up children, both of you, what was their reaction after seeing the show? Because kids this age tend to get embarrassed with anything their parents do. What was their reaction?
My younger one is too young. He's 9, but the first day he was very confused. Said, why is my mom? He kept asking me, Mama, why are you doing this? And I don't want to be seen on TV. A little bit, he was confused. But the next morning, I know he was secretly checking Netflix. Mama, it was number one. Mama, your show is number one. He went mental. And then so people started sending him very sweetly. He's getting little gifts like boxes of candy, and someone sent him Nutella, and someone sent him. He's thinking that he's become the most important person on the planet. He's loving it. And my older one, Nirvan, he was in America when it dropped. And he didn't say much to me. He was like, he was waiting for it. And he said, yeah, Mama, you know. And then when he came back, he came home. He said, okay, listen, you know what? I don't want your head to get too inflated, but it's damn good. So I had to kind of read the lines because, you know, boys don't say too much. But I know that he's proud. I can feel it. I mean, he will not say it in so many words, but you know your boys, you know your kid.
And you do come across as one of those mommies who's constantly keeping a check on them, a little hyper. You know, that came across, right?
Guilty. I'm trying. Told in many comments that you need to let go. And I'm like, I have these kids for me. So let me enjoy it while I can. And as long as he allows me, I'm going to do it. When I'm out.
And then the tiger mommy, Maheep, what have been your kids' reaction? We did see Shania a lot, and a lot of people also said, is this Shania's launch pad, which you had said, this is not her launch pad. I mean, you know, so what has it been like for you? How have the kids reacted? And you seem to be one cool mom, yeah, using just very bindas, as they say, with the kids around.
I'm not as cool as you think I am. Especially when Nights Out happen, I'm very like, I think Seema cleared it in the show. Yeah. Like, kid, 2 o'clock, it's 2 o'clock. I am like that. But Jahan, when he saw the trailer, he was like, Mama, my teachers are going to see this. You know that, na? So I said, but I asked you and whatever. Anyway, after the show dropped, Shania was like, she was so excited. She's so proud. She was telling me all her friends from London, from New York, they were messaging me and they loved the show. So, and so even Jahan, his friends were calling up and everything. And Shania was very clear at the beginning. And I think I mentioned it to you before that, you know, live the adventure, have the stories to tell. And I wouldn't have been on board if my kids had not said, yes, Mama, you can do it. If they had said, no, you know, you're going to embarrass us and we'll feel humiliated or we'll feel whatever. No ways would I have done it. But they love the show.
Awesome. So and how has it changed for the four of you? Has anything changed post this show in your dynamics? Has anything changed? For the four of you, because now your lives are out in the open, because the thing is what you all did in private is now very public. So has anything changed?
No, I don't think anything has changed between the four of us. In fact, I think that we're more bonded because now we're constantly in touch, you know, like, of course, we've always been in touch, but not to this level where we are like, we have a group chat and we're exchanging messages and we're talking to each other like 4 times a day. So it's, I think more than anything, it's brought us even closer. We have one more story to tell. We have one more milestone, like Maheep says, under our belt. So I think that is like, it's a huge achievement for us. And it's a memory that the four of us have made together that it's going to be unforgettable.
And Mahi, what do you have to say? Also, another thing that a lot of people were discussing on groups is like, ye sab English mein kyun baat kar rahe hain? Hindi kyun nahi aati hai? What would you tell them?
My Hindi is bad. Now, if you want to troll me for that, go for it. What should I say? My Hindi is bad. But, so I want to spare everybody hearing me speak Hindi.
My but... season 2 mein shudh Hindi mein, thoda sa.
Chalo, let's see. Maybe.
So what more? I mean, how has it changed the dynamics?
I think that a lot has changed, yet nothing has changed between us. we're still absorbing it. It's 3 weeks only. We're still like understanding what has happened. We were all very sure that people would be curious to see the show, but for it to blow up the way it has, that we weren't expecting. And I've said this before, it's just another added milestone with all of us as friends. So it just bonds us a lot more when something like this mammoth, massive thing that's happened, you know, it just bonds you a lot more. We get each other, we understand each other, we get the trolls, you know, we're always, like we've got each other's back, put it that way, a lot more.
Okay, so there was one particular scene where Seema forgets to get your clothes made for the big party. What happened post that? I was very curious because poor Maheep is sitting like this, like everyone's got their clothes. Yeah. What happened? What was the damage control done?
She had a very nice outfit. Her outfit was stunning. I was not concerned at all because her backup was fab. And it's Maheep. She understands me and I was under a lot of pressure. So honestly, I was pushed for time. I was under pressure and Maheep had a fab outfit. I didn't want to compete with that.
Listen, if season two she does this to me again, there'll be fireworks. That's for sure. That's all I want to say. And ended at that.
Awesome. But Maheep, you do plan the most fabulous holidays, I must say, yeah?
Well, I'm just the planner now. And the holiday was amazing. Doha was just out of this world. We had a blast. And I was very, very clear. Even next season, if this happens, I'll be very, very clear again. They can cry and do whatever. Everyone has to be glamorous, dress up, heels, whatever, whatever. But that's going to be my thing for even next season, if next season happens.
It's very popular. So Seema, what was your takeaway about Maheep after the show ended? I'm sure you all discovered something about the other once the show was done.
You know, I know Maheep too well. As in with us, there is no topic that's off the table. So the thing is that I didn't discover anything about her, but together we discovered a lot. We discovered, mm-hmm. I think, you know, we are having the similar feelings. Our lives are changing in the similar manner, and we're enjoying mm-hmm. this together, which is just an amazing feeling. Because how many people can say they do this together, like so four friends? I mean, what we're sharing. How many people actually get to do this in a lifetime? So I think that this milestone has been an achievement. It's a huge achievement for us at this point in our lives. And there's nothing, I'm just very proud of Maheep, because the thing is that a lot of people don't, you know, understand her when she put her language or herself out there, the way she talks. She's a bloody fierce woman. And I think a lot of women want to be that, but they don't have the guts, and she's got the balls. So I think a lot of
women... And Seema.
You know, but Maheep, it's amazing. Through the... And I agree with her, because through the show, you know, you came across the gutsy one that, you know, nothing ruffles her feather, but they also showed your vulnerable side. There were moments when you were talking to Karan and also when you were speaking to Shah Rukh, the vulnerability also came out, you know. So, I mean, was that totally unexpected? It just came out, because you came actually across as the strongest of the four, if I may. So, you know, the demeanor was like nothing can face her.
But even strong women have those emotions and those feelings, you know. It's such a misconception that just because you're strong, you don't hurt and you don't feel. So, yeah, when Karan did speak to me on that helipad, yeah, it's the truth. You know, we've gone through our ups and downs, and he knows it also. Seema knows it also. So it was the truth, and it just came out spontaneously. And I'm glad it did, because I think women should understand it's also important to put out your vulnerable side also. It's also good to express yourself. So
were you reprimanded by family or by a mom or your dad? Any ganiyan kyun ditti? As they say in Punjabi.
Honestly, I was expecting my mother-in-law. Even Sanjay said, I'm really surprised mom didn't fire you. So I was expecting my mother-in-law. So my mother-in-law says, Nini, bahut achhi thi, aur bahut achha show tha. Ab bhi main thak gayi hun, kal dekhungi. So she's been seeing one episode a day and she's loving it. So even my mom and dad were focused on the grandkids. They were like, oh, Shanai came on. Oh, Jahan came on. I was like, I'm in the show also. My son-in-law also. So, yeah, they were fine. I warned them before also. I said, do not give me any lectures. I had warned my mom.
And also, like, you know, Seema also, you know, I could relate to you also, you know, she's high for one moment, then she's calm one moment, she overreact, then she will not. What was your takeaway about yourself after the show?
But, you know, that is me as a person. I'm like a soda bottle. I go to that fizz and then I'm done. It's like, I need to, when I feel something, I need to get it out of my system. And I'm a bit of a loner. So there are times that I've, in the room, but I'm not in the room. I've kind of drifted. I'm a Pisces. I'm a dreamer. I kind of drift at times. But the whole show, I think the most surprising thing was that I had a lot of people who've known me for years, and they said, oh, you know what? We didn't know that there was this side to you. But the thing is, to get this out, this is me. But this is me with people that I'm extremely comfortable with, where I'm in my safe zone, where I'm in my comfort zone. And this was it. So for me, this is actually who I am, completely unfiltered. And as you can see, I have this thing about me is I have no filter. I do not know when. My biggest drawback is actually I don't know when to stop, because with me, what I'm thinking and what I'm feeling will come out. I don't know any other way to be. They can, you know, they're pretending. I'm so bad at it. I'm so bad at it because I can never do it. So they say, and I even, my friends tell me, like, if there's something I don't like about a person or whatever, you put me in that room, behave. Sure, I can give the stink eye.
Like, I relate to that. And Mahip, you do realize, you know, Sanjay has come out as like the one of the most favorite people, because there were comments saying, oh, Sanjay Kapoor is such a dad. Oh, Sanjay Kapoor, such a nice Punjabi munda. Has Sanjay also read all those comments, and how has he taken those?
Yeah, yeah. He was in Nasik shooting, and he told me every time I gave a shot, I was coming back to my phone, I had 10, 15 messages. So he says, this is really not normal. This is very rare what's happening, you know? So even he was also absorbing it, you know? I'm glad that people got him and understood his dad side or his jokes. After 25 years of marriage, you know, I don't laugh at his jokes anymore. I used to. So I didn't know that people would get them and find it so funny, but I'm glad they did.
Sorry, but I laugh at all his jokes.
Yes, she does. Seema is obsessed with Sanjay.
He's a very entertaining human. Let me tell you, there's never a dull moment around him. There are annoying moments, lots of dull ones. Sorry.
Awesome. Also, ladies, how much of it was scripted, or was it just extempo? And when the cameras were rolling, were you aware? Because you're used to cameras following you, I know. But this is different. It's in your home, you know. But I know there were certain, you know, like your private spaces were out of bounds. But what was it like? Was it scripted? And what was it like with the cameras constantly on you? Were you conscious about it?
Look, I think at first it was very daunting, but we had a pilot where it was a teaser. Sorry. Yes, darling. So my son and his homework. Anyway, I have to upload it. He does the homework, but I have to upload it anyway. So, I think we had a kind of a teaser with the pilot. So I knew what was to come, but it was of course very, very daunting. But I think between the pilot and when we actually started filming, it was a good 6 months. So we kind of got to know the whole crew and everyone, and they became a part of our lives.
I think the daunting part was initially signing on for the show, and the thought that, you know, we're exposing our lives, we're exposing our children, our homes, and we're going to be up for judgment. Once I got over that, it was almost liberating, because I was like, listen, why should I care? You know, I should live this adventure. Very few people have this opportunity to do what I'm doing, and I must grab it. So once I got over that, it was fine. And shooting with your friends, you know, it was like a cakewalk. And like Seema said, the crew was so amazing that, you know, when you're in your four walls and you're talking to your friends, it doesn't matter. But what was very important for all of us is that we didn't want to be insensitive to anybody. So the crew also had our back.
And did you read the best repartee that came from Karan to a troll, right? When they said, oh, you are the favorite wife. And he was like,
yeah.
That so has, you gone through all, Have you all gone through all the comments? Something that made you laugh? Any particular comment that you read that just made you laugh, like the one Karan commented on, you know, just went viral. Anything that you've read about yourself that you were like, oh my God.
I think that Atul Khatri had made this whole meme of me looking through the binoculars. I put it up. That made me laugh a lot. I loved that. I loved it.
I'm not a stalker, but I do like to check out my Juhu neighborhood.
I think I'll take a bath here.
I mean...
Mahip, stop it, yeah. Shwai.
I don't know. I just don't know how to react to that.
What about you, Seema? Anything about you that came out?
You know, about me in particular, no, but there was so much... Actually, there have been so many comments and there have been so much of feedback that I'm laughing. But yeah, I got a message the next morning from Kiara. I won't forget because it was the next morning and I got a message from her with a video clip that, when I was talking to that guy in Hindi, tu itna proud kyun ho raha? I'd forgotten I said that. I have laughed and laughed. I said, you know what? Imagine... She knows now how mad I can actually be. I'm completely bad.
Before we conclude, Shahrukh had shown this picture of Mahi. Can you see that?
Yes.
Can you tell us the history? Please, can you tell us the history? What was it? What was going on at that moment?
Honestly, I don't know what to say, but I was in my 20s and this film came to me. And I'm fortunate enough to shoot half a film. And I did the ultimate Hindi film scene where I was in a mini skirt in the snow with my hero. And I've done that song. So I've experienced it, but I can now safely say at 47 that I am, when I look back, I know I was a very, very bad actor. So I'm glad that it got shelved. And that I would have had another set of trolls then if that film had released. They would have attacked me, you know? That how dare you come into Hindi cinema, you're the worst, and whatever. So I'm very grateful to that. And I got married, I think the film got shelved by February. By December, I was married. And within a month, I was pregnant with Shania. So that's really the history.
Awesome. So before we wrap, never have I ever been through my children's stuff, snooped.
No. That I've not.
Seema?
Okay.
Seema
has. Listen, I have boys. I have a teenage. I have boys. And at times it's a necessity for a mom to do it. But to be honest with you, no. Barring that one hour, I can't even remember actually when I've ever snooped through stuff. I've never needed to. Actually, my son is a good boy. Thankfully. He's a good boy.
So never have I ever gone through Sanjay's phone book.
No. Never. But then he cannot look through my phone also. It's a rule with us. It's a sacred rule. You don't go through my phone, I will go through your phone. But I don't. Not at all.
Seema, never ever re-gifted the girls a gift that you had received from someone.
Never. If I've ever gotten something that I think would be special for one of them, I will tell them and I will keep it aside for them because I think that they would want it more than me. Maybe I would have done that in the past. I don't know. But re-gifted something like that, never.
Never have I ever unfollowed a friend on social media.
I have. I've unfollowed many people. Especially during this 2020, my mind and my positivity was very sacred to me. You know, everything was negative, everything was dark. So if there were people that were upsetting me, I said, listen, it's better to unfollow because I don't want to see it. So I have many.
Seema.
Yeah, I have. I've definitely, you know what? I don't like dark, gloomy.
Seema, are you frozen?
No. Am I frozen?
No.
I don't like
gloomy,
negative people. I like to feel good. At the end of the day, when I go to bed, and my social media is something, right? So that's, I have unfollowed people.
Never have I ever dined and dashed.
Never have I ever dined and dashed.
Dashed.
I've done it many times.
No. Once I'm out there, I'm like, listen, just get me my wine. Then I'm like, okay, to get to me, there's a problem. But then I don't dash. No.
I dash.
Never have I ever... Never have I ever danced in the elevator.
I have.
Okay, and I never have I ever, Mahi, tried to match my colors with my partner's colors.
No, I think that's no. Hell no, not that.
All right, ladies, fabulous speaking to you. Hope that we get to see season 2 of Fabulous Lives of Bollywood Wives. Maybe Neelam would have said yes to the film offer. Who knows? Mahip also may just say yes to another film offer. It just might come, yeah?
Sign me at your own risk. That's all I can say. To whoever's even thinking about it.
What about you, Seema? No plans to also sign a show if it comes your way, as they're saying, like one show per season?
No. I did because it was my friends, but that's not for me. And I'm just enjoying what I've got so far.
All right. Thank you so much, ladies, for making us laugh in this year. I mean, one could not ignore you all.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. All the very best and Happy New Year. Hope 2021 brings good cheer and good fortune for all of us.
You too.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Bye.